Good day guys, welcome back to another tutorial online with Olasende Fit. And this time around we are treating CHM101 and we're starting off with stoichiometry of reaction. But before we get to stoichiometry of reaction, check this out guys. This is my channel analytics page and it has been known that my watch time from subscribers, majority of them are not subscribed. Majority of my viewers are not subscribed. Please do my channel a favor by hitting that subscribe button. This channel will stay with you till the end of your stay in Funab. One way of encouraging my help is to hit that subscribe button. Please help me reach the 500 subscribers mark by the end of this year. That is my goal for this year. Please help me achieve this. And thank you for staying with me this far. Stoichiometry of reaction. Stoichiometry of reaction actually is just the way substances, elements or compounds, the way they relate in a chemical reaction, how their quantities relate in a chemical reaction. That is the simplest way I can define stoichiometry of reaction. Having said that, let's now go into the calculation properly, since that is actually what we need. Now the calculations to stoichiometry of reaction, I'm going to start from the base so that you understand the tough one. I'll start from the smallest one. Okay, now I have taken the liberty to break it into three, though you won't find it like that in textbooks. So from where I understand, I've broken stoichiometry of reaction into three basics from which others build. Starting with the first one, we have mole to mole. I've named it mole to mole, which is actually the simplest. Mole to mole. How do they relate? Mole to mole. How do they relate in a compound, in a chemical reaction? How do they relate mole to mole? Okay. Now let's take this equation, chemical equation. H plus N. Forward reaction NH3. I believe we know how to balance chemical reactions. That one shouldn't be a problem. Okay, now how do they relate mole to mole? You'd realize that 3 moles of hydrogen reacts with 2 moles of nitrogen to form 2 moles of ammonia. I believe we can see it is very clear, isn't it? Okay, now the question might now come this way. From this reaction above, how many moles of N will be needed to produce 6 moles of ammonia? The question can come this way. Firstly, the rule is that firstly go to the standard. And what is the standard? The standard is what you already have in the equation. Go to the standard. What is the standard telling you? The standard tells me here that 3 moles. The standard tells me that 3 moles of hydrogen, when it reacts with nitrogen, it will give 2 moles of ammonia, isn't it? That's what the standard tells. The standard has given the basis for the stoichiometry, that's given the basis with which these quantities are relating. So any other one should be based on this one. Now, how do you now get the answer? Well, there's actually a long protocol, but since we are not following the long protocol, let me just mention the long protocol first, then I'll go to the faster one, and you can always stick with the faster one, but then you understand the long protocol. Okay, how do you get this? This is the long protocol. Now, how do you solve this? This is the long protocol. Now, the one you are trying to find should be on the right side. Like, since you are trying to find hydrogen, how many moles of hydrogen, it should come to the right whereas the one given should be on the left, on your left. Okay, now this is what I mean. Since this is what we are given, I want to start with the standard. We say 2 moles of ammonia is produced from 3 moles of hydrogen. That is the standard. Now let's now break it to what one will produce. 1 mole of ammonia should produce or will produce 3/2. You have to divide it, moles of hydrogen. You are dividing it. Since this one turns to 1, it's just like say divide both sides by 2. So if you divide both sides by 2, this one turns to 1, this one turns to 3/3. Now the last step will now be, now this one that we are given, 6 moles, how many should it produce? 6 moles of ammonia will now produce 3/2 times 6 moles of hydrogen. So you can then go out, solve, and get your answer. That means 6 moles of ammonia should be produced from 9 moles of hydrogen. This is actually the long protocol. And I know some of you might be wondering, why should this place be reduced to 1? Now, if I asked you a question, for example, you have 2 eggs, and these 2 eggs can make you 4 sandwiches. These 2 eggs can make you 4 sandwiches. And you're now asked, okay, if 2 eggs can make you 4 sandwiches, how many eggs will make you 10 sandwiches? That would be the question. How many eggs can make you 10 sandwiches? Now, if I asked you the question, what would first come to your mind? You say if 2 can make 4. So that means 1 egg will make 2 sandwiches. So, and I need to make 10. So you can just be adding that 2. That'll be 5 places. So you can now come to a conclusion that 5 eggs should be able to make 10 sandwiches. The fact that you broke it down first to 1 is what I'm trying to bring out here. It's just like you're doing simple mathematics here. So you first break it down to 1 so that you can know what any number will give you. That's the rule. And like I told you, this is how you do it the long way. But since you're not really doing theory, you're just doing OBJ. So let's just go straight to what you need in OBJ. So what you need in OBJ is, first you write out the standard. Hydrogen, 3 hydrogen should give you 2 ammonia. That's from the standard first. So how many hydrogen will give you, how many hydrogen should give 6 ammonia? Now that's the question. Cross multiply. 2x equals 3 times 6. 2x equals 3 times 6, 18. X equals to 18 divided by 2, which is 9. So 9 moles. 9 moles. So this is how you do it in your OBJ. So you just work it out fast and go to the next. Okay, now that's mole to mole. Let's go to mass to mass. What I named mass to mass. So mass to mass. Mass to mass, this time around we are relating the mass of the substance to the mass of the other. So let's still go with our hydrogen plus nitrogen giving us our almighty ammonia. Okay, let's first relate their masses. We know that the mass of hydrogen here should be what? Remember I've taught you molar mass, calculating molar mass. Hydrogen, this is hydrogen here. Hydrogen is originally 1. 1 times 2 times 3. This 3 will multiply everything, remember. And 2 will multiply, it will multiply. This subscript will multiply just the element that carries it. So 2 times 3, 6. So 6 grams, that's the mass of hydrogen here. mass of nitrogen. Nitrogen is 14 times 2. That's 28 grams. Now, nitrogen here is 20. That's, let's quickly calculate this, 2NH3. Nitrogen, remember these two will multiply everything. So nitrogen here is already 28 plus hydrogen here is already 6. So that's 32 grams. Is it 32? 34 grams. So 34 grams. I believe we all understand what I've just done here. Now, how do you relate the mass to mass? We're still going to base this off of what we've done in mole to mole. So if the question now goes like this, what mass of nitrogen is required to produce 14 grams of ammonia? If the question goes this way, now because mass is what is being related to mass here, so that's why it is mass to mass. That's why I named it mass to mass. So now we need to first remember, go with the standard first. You need to first work out the standard nitrogen, and I've already explained how it should be done in the long sense. What if you are following the long sense, just check. You can go rewind, go back to the way we did for mole to mole, so that you can know how to do it for mass to mass. It's still just the same thing, just follow the step, you still get the answer. But since we are dealing with OBJ here, let's just go straight to what we need. So mass to mass, firstly go to the standard. That's the first thing to do. Go to the standard. Nitrogen here is 28 grams. Nitrogen should produce 34 grams ammonia. That's based on the standard. Now your question now says, how many nitrogen should be produced from 14 grams? Should produce 14 grams ammonia. Then you cross multiply 34 times x, 28 times 14. Then 34x equals, so the rest is all simple mathematics, and you keep calculating. 28 times 14 is 392. Then x becomes 392 divided by 34. Then x becomes 11.5 grams. So 11.5 grams is required. So that's basically mass to mass. It's simple. And I want to believe that the last one too should be very simple, since it's basically we are following the same process. So the next one is volume to volume. And I want to believe that if you have followed it right from the beginning, you should already understand how volume to volume should go. So let's still stick with our hydrogen plus nitrogen giving us ammonia. Okay, let's just stick with this and volume to volume. So volume to volume, the question goes this way. Now before we go to the question, in a standard at STP, the one mole of a substance at STP is 22.4 dm cubed. At STP, so I need you guys to know this. Now, so if this is it, that means what should be the volume of this? Since we want to assume that it is at STP, that should be 67.2. Yeah, you're right. dm cube. Then this one should be 44.8 dm cube. Just multiply it with the number of moles. This one should be 44.8 dm cube. Okay, now if the question now goes this way, what volume of nitrogen is required to produce 10 dm cube of ammonia? It's actually simple. just follow the protocol, follow the process. First go to the standard. Nitrogen and ammonia is what we are dealing with here. So nitrogen and ammonia, nitrogen, the mass of nitrogen, the volume of nitrogen here is 44.8 dm³. Nitrogen should also give 44.8 dm³. Ammonia. So how many volume of nitrogen can give 10 dm³ ammonia? So cross multiply and you get the answer. At the end of the day, it is still 10 dm³ of nitrogen. I believe we understand that. I believe it is well understood. So that's volume to volume. Now, these are just the basics. How would you get it in a typical exam? In a typical exam, it shouldn't be this easy. Naturally, it should not be this easy. Okay? You might not get a question like this in exam. Let's consider this equation. Now, these are the question will go. These are your seats. Now, this time around, the question goes, calculate the number of moles of ammonia that can be produced in the reaction of hydrogen with 2 grams of nitrogen. Now, usually they want to confuse you. You'll be like, okay, which one should I pick? Is it hydrogen and ammonia? Or is it nitrogen and ammonia? Yeah, it's usually confused. They usually do this just to confuse you, confuse students. It's actually very simple. You don't have to be confused. The one you are picking is the one given versus the one you are not given versus the one you are to find. The one given versus the one you are to find. This is the one that you have been given here. 2 grams of nitrogen. This hydrogen is also tell you that nitrogen is reacting with hydrogen to give ammonia. That's just this hydrogen is just to confuse or to make you understand the question very well. That's just it. So the one given versus the one you have to calculate, and you are told to calculate ammonia, isn't it? So straightforward. Now nitrogen and ammonia, that's what you are dealing with. But this time around, you need to understand their unit, their quantity. Nitrogen, they are referring to nitrogen in terms of its mass. So this time around, when you are going to the standard, you must relate with nitrogen in terms of its mass. And ammonia, they are referring to ammonia in terms of its number of mole. So that means if you are going back to the standard, you must relate with ammonia in terms of its number of moles. So how do you do that? So going back to the standard, we can then say the mass of nitrogen is 14. So since nitrogen is 2 here, so it should be 28. So we can then say 28 grams of nitrogen should produce 2 moles of ammonia. I believe we understand that. The mole of ammonia is what we are using in relation with the mass of nitrogen. So you always pick the quantities of each stated to work with. So this is where they have mixed mole to mole, mass to mass, whatsoever. It is already mixed up here. So continuing with this, now we can then now go to what the question now states. The question now states that 2 grams of ammonia should give us how many number of moles of that 2 grams of nitrogen should give us how many number of moles of ammonia. That's what the question now states. So the rest is actually easy. Then 28x, 2 times 2, 4, 28x, x equals to 4 over 28, and 4 divided by 28, 0.14 moles. And how do I know that it is moles? Because I'm always going to be, okay, how do I know it's moles? Why is it not mass? Because x here is, x on this side, x is on this side, which is moles of hydrogen ammonia that you have to find. Assuming x is on this side, then it will be mass, because it is mass that is being related on this side. So that's basically it, guys. That's just it. So anything, any other stoichiometry that comes, just solve it this way, then you're good to go. Before we go, let's just treat another one. In case if you're told to do this, I believe you should understand this. So volume, they are relating to ammonia in terms of its volume. So going to the standard, the volume of ammonia is 44.8 dm³ of ammonia, and they are relating to hydrogen in terms of its mole, so 3 moles of hydrogen. Then now go to the question, calculate the volume of this is x and this is 6. So I believe this is well understood. So the answer should be 89.6 dm³ of ammonia. So basically, this is stoichiometry of reaction, guys. I believe this is well understood. If you have any question, drop them in the comments below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Do my channel a favor by subscribing. I'm on the road to 500 subs. Please help me achieve this before the end of this year. Thank you. Ciao.